my God.
Baby, what's the matter? Baby, don't tell me you are still sitting here. The food I prepared is still on the dining table, untouched. Or do you want me to feed you?
No, I don't just have the appetite to eat anything.
But you know I put in a lot of effort to prepare that food. You have to eat, even if it's little. You can't keep starving yourself. What has happened has happened. We will try again. It's not the end of the world.
Caleb, I miscarried my first baby. Do you know how painful it is?
I understand, dear. I'm also hurt, but I know everything will be fine. It's just a miscarriage. The doctor said it's as a result of stress. So, all we have to do is to make sure you are not stressed next time. Everything will be fine. I am here for you.
How did I get so lucky to have a man like you? I don't know what I would have done without you. Thanks for being by my side.
You can thank me by standing up and going to eat the delicious delicacy I prepared for you.
I think I have my appetite back.
That's my girl.
Now, wow, just take a look at what I have become. A mere errand boy for my best friend. I am even thankful that he accepted me into his house at all, because I don't deserve his help. Ah, and I'm even thankful that I failed the test, because only God knows the sacrifice that would be involved in returning the money. I allowed pride get into my head, to the extent of treating all my friends like trash. I also allowed myself to be carried away by frivolities, to the extent of squandering all the money without investing in a single thing. I deserve whatever is happening to me now. I have learned my lessons the hard way. I just have to be patient and hope my situation turns around for the better.
Babe, you really have to stop working for now.
Why? But I'm just a month gone.
The doctor attributed stress as one of the causes of the last miscarriage. I don't want what happened the last time to repeat itself, so we need to take extra precaution.
Can't I work till I'm 5 months gone at least?
No. You are stopping immediately. I'm capable of taking care of the family without you having to work, and you know it.
Okay, if you insist.
I insist. Please, just do this for me. It's for our own good.
I know. I'll do anything for us, for our baby.
That's why I'll keep loving you more.
Hello?
Hi, it's Ben. How are you doing?
I'm good.
I've been thinking...
I know what you're thinking and what you want. I'm not interested.
Jessica, why don't you give me a chance to prove that I am different? Your friend told me that you have been hurt terribly in your last relationship, and that's why you are acting this way.
What? What exactly did Benita tell you?
She didn't give me details. I pressurized her before she was even able to tell me that you were hurt in your past relationship. She didn't want to tell me anything at all. Please, can we meet and talk?
No, I am not interested.
Just to talk. Please, I promise you that I won't pressure you whatsoever to do what you don't want to do. I just want to talk, please.
Okay, I'll see you this once. And that's it. I am not interested in any relationship.
Thank you so much. You don't know how happy I am to hear this.
Don't get too excited. I'll text you the address of where we'll meet. Bye.
I'm so excited for you, girl. You are finally leaving your shell.
I only said I'll be seeing him tonight. I am not accepting to be his woman. So better keep your excitement in your pocket.
You are going out with him. It's something. Ever since Caleb left, you have never looked at any other man. So I'm excited that you are giving Ben an opportunity. I really like that Ben of a guy. You. He seems nice.
Well, that's the same thing you said about Caleb. That made me give myself completely to him. only to discover he is a beast. Please don't even try to help Ben at all. Just leave him alone. Let me decide myself if he is nice or not.
Whatever. How was I supposed to know that Caleb wasn't who he claimed to be? He was really romantic, so caring and loving. Never imagined it would do something like that to you.
That's why I'm asking you not to hype Ben for me.
Okay, oh, I've heard you.
Thank you once more for accepting to go out with me. I really appreciate.
What exactly do you want? I expected you would be tired by now and leave me alone.
And you think I haven't tried that?
You have?
Yes, several times, but there's something about you that makes my heart refuse to let you go. I have gotten tired of the chase several times, but I can't leave.
I see, but the truth is, my heart is not ready to get tangled in any form of relationship. So I guess you'll have to go in the long run.
I won't.
Oh, really?
Yes, Jessica, I understand that you might have gone through a lot in your past relationship to make you doubt me, but I can assure you that all men are not the same. You will experience what it means to be loved properly, if only you can open your heart.
Wow, nice try, but I'm still not convinced. Maybe you should try another line.
Listen, the world we live in is a very harsh one. We meet bad people who cause us pain and sorrow. And we also meet good people who help redefine us in a positive way, who make us happy and love us. It would be very unwise to deny yourself love and happiness with good people who really care about you because of your bad experience with the ones.
The food is nice. What do you think?
Jessica.
We should come here again. Their food is superb.
Really? Is that all you have to say to what I just told you?
And their services is also top-notch. I would definitely be coming here again.